Hi friends, good evening. Welcome to our Aptitude training session 3. So let's wait for a few minutes. Few students will join with us. In the meantime, if you are able to get audio, clear audio and video, just let me know through comments. Okay, so it seems audio and video is clear. So in our previous session, we have discussed profit and loss, percentage, simple and compound interest in the session 2. Okay. So today we are going to discuss an interesting topic in quantitative aptitude, ratio and proportion and partnership. So we use this concept ratio and proportion in partnership, time and work, time and distance, and ages. So today we are going to discuss this ratio and proportion, and then we'll discuss the partnership. So this is the plan for the day. First we'll discuss what is placement is an online course. Then we'll discuss our topic ratio and proportion, partnership. At the end I will tell you about the offers and coupon code available which you can use to purchase the test from us and practice. So first, what is placement season online training? So today we are conducting the third session. So like this, we will be conducting Facebook live training session on all aptitude topics on every Wednesday. So every Wednesday at 8 p.m. you can attend this aptitude training through Facebook webinar. So this video will be recorded and it will be stored in prep.placementseason.com. And you can access the same video in app.placementseason.com. Also, you can access this video in our YouTube channel also. So, apart from this training video, you will have the concept video which is available in prep.placementseason.com and app.placementseason.com. So, if you have any doubt in particular concept, you can open and search the topic and then you can practice the problem in prepare placement season test package. And this test package is exclusively for 2019 batch. Okay. Let's move on to our topic. So first, let's see what is ratio. So ratio is comparing two similar terms in its lowest form. So let's say we are comparing the speed of car and speed of bus. In general, we write the ratio like this: A is to B or A by B. So assume the speed of car is 120 km per hour and speed of bus is 100 km per hour. So let's see here. So 120 is to 100. So if I write in fraction, I will get 120 by 100. So simplify this value and you will get 6 by 5. So if you write in terms of ratio, it is 6 is to 5. So 6:5 is the ratio between speed of car and speed of bus if their speed is 120 km per hour and 100 km per hour respectively. So look at this ratio 6:5. So in this ratio we have 11 parts, that is 6 plus 5 is 11. So among these 11 parts, 6 parts belongs to car and 5 parts belongs to bus. Similarly, if ratio between A is to B is 2:3. So in this total 5 parts, 2 parts belongs to A and 3 parts belongs to B. So now assume a ratio A is to B. I am multiplying this ratio with a value m. So if I multiply, I get m into A is to m into B. If I divide this ratio by n, I will get A by n is to B by n. Or I can do both, multiplication and division. So if I multiply by m and divide by n, I will get m into A by n is to m into b by n. So all these values are same. So among this, we'll take the simplest form as a ratio. Next, proportion. What is proportion? It's equality between two ratios. So consider the ratio A is to b and c is to d here. So here A, B, C and D are first, second, third and fourth proportion respectively. So in this, A and D are at extreme ends. So this is called the extreme proportion. Here B and C are mean proportion. Now write the ratio in terms of fraction. I am writing in terms of fraction A by B equal to C by B. So cross multiply this value, A into D equal to B into C. So if you look at this, A and D are extreme proportion, B and C are mean proportion. So it means that the product of extreme proportion equal to product of mean proportion. So remember this, we will use this concept in problems. So let's take a simple example. So divide 672 in the ratio of 5:3. So they have given the ratio as 5:3. Hence total parts equal to 8 parts. So we have to divide this 672 into 672 in the ratio of 5:3. So the simple method is 672 by 8. You will get 1 part. So multiply this with 5. Similarly, 672 by 8, you will get 1 part. Multiply with 3. So this is the traditional method we used to solve this problem. So in the other way you can also solve. So total part is 8 part. In that 8 part you need to find the 5 parts. So multiply with total part. Similarly, among 8 parts you need to find the 3 parts. Multiply this 72. So the mathematical term will be the same, but you can directly substitute among 8 part you need to 5 parts. So among 8 part you need to find 3 parts. So if you simplify, you will get 420 and 252. So if you divide 672 in the ratio of 5:3, you will get this value, 422 and 252. Okay. So let's discuss this problem. So we have 4 different types of problem in this ratio and proportion. So let's start with the basic ratio and proportion. So after completing this, we'll discuss a problem based on amount distribution, and then we'll discuss how to find new ratio if they have given some ratio. So, and finally we'll discuss combined ratio. Let's start with first type of problem. A company X sells TV at price of ₹7,000, whereas another company Y sells the same TV at the price of ₹16,800. What is the ratio of their respective selling price? This is the question. So as per definition, we know the ratio is comparing similar term in its lowest form. So here we are comparing the selling price of TV. So the value is 7000 and another TV price is 16800. So as per definition, we have to simplify. So if I simplify, I'll get 10 is to 24. If I get simplify again, I'll get 5 is to 12. So 5 is to 12 is the ratio between the selling price of two products. So let's discuss example. In an entrance test, the ratio of applicants to successful students was 21 is to 11. So here they have given applicant is to successfully clear students. So 21 students appear and 11 students has cleared this test successfully. So it means among 21 students, 11 students has cleared the test. So in this example, they have given if 1176 students appeared in the test, how many got through it? So they have given the value 1176 students appear and how many students successfully clear. So we have studied in percentage, profit and loss. So simply cross multiply this value and get the answer. So 1176 into 11 by 20 will get the answer. So if you simplify, you will get 616. So just look at this term here. The ratio is 21 is to 11. So in the question itself, they have given total number of students is 21. So it means if you write 21 part, among 21 parts, 11 parts belongs to successful candidates. So you can also use this technique to solve the problem. Answer will be same. Here, don't add this ratio. They have given directly 21. 21 is the total value. So among 21, successful clear student ratio is 11. So substitute this and get the answer. Let's move on to the second type of problem. It's distributing amount between two or three persons. So in this example, a profit of 8000 is to be distributed among A, B and C in the proportion of 5:2:3 respectively. 5:2:3 respectively. So what is the difference between the shares of A and B? Here they have given A:B:C equal to 5:2:3. So in this, we need to find the value of amount of A, amount of B, and we have to find the difference. So just look at this. So among 10 parts, if you add 5:2:3, you will get 10. Among 10, 5 parts belongs to A and the profit which we have received is 8000. Simplify this. If you simplify, we will get 4000. So in the second thing, we have to find the share of B. So B have 2 parts. Among 10 parts, it will receive 2 parts. So total value is 8000. So if you simplify, you will get 6000. So our question is, what is the difference between shares of A and B? So if you subtract, you will get 2400. So instead of doing this, this is a method to solve the problem. Let me tell you an alternate method to solve this problem. Here, look at the difference. So difference between A and B is 5 - 2, it is 3. So 3 parts. So you have to simply find what is 3 part. So total profit is 8000. So we are dividing into 10 part and what is 3. So simplify this and you will get. So 800 into 3, we will get the answer 2400. So you can use any method to solve this problem. So instead of calculating A share and B share separately, you can directly calculate the difference between A and B share and consider it as individual part. Then substitute the value and get the answer. Okay. So let's discuss one more problem in amount distribution. A sum of money is divided among 4 candidates, that is A, B, C and D, in the ratio of 3:5:8:9. If the share of D is 1872 more than the share of A, then what is the total amount of money of B and C together? Okay. So let's look at this. A:B:C:8. So the ratio is 3:5:8:9. So they have given the share of D is rupees 1872 more than the share of A. So before calculating the share value, subtract the ratio of D and A. So you'll get 9 minus 3, you'll get 6. So it means 6 part is equal to 1872. So what is the question? What is the total amount of money of B and C together? So if you add the value of the ratio of B and C, you will get 13. So they have given 6 part equal to 1872. And what is the value of 13? So simply cross multiply and you will get the answer. 872 into 13 divided by 6. So if you simplify, you will get 4056. So no need to calculate the A share separately, D share, and then no need to calculate the amount. So directly use the concept of number of parts. If one part is equal to this much, and what is how much the remaining part. So let's move on to the third type in this. Here we are going to find the new ratio. A, B and C divide an amount of rupees 2800 among themselves in the ratio of 5 is to 6 is to 3 respectively. If an amount of 200 is added to each of their shares, what is the new ratio of their shares of amount? So here the profit they have received is rupees 2800. They are sharing the ratio, they are sharing the profit in the ratio of 5 is to 6 is to 3. So A is to B is to C equal to 5 is to 6 is to 3. So the total value is, the total part is 14 parts. So among this, A receive 5 part in this, the total value is 2800. So simplify this, you will get 1000. Similarly, find the amount, profit amount for B. So 6 by 14 into 2800 equal to 1200, and find the profit of C. So 3 by 14 equal to 2800 equal to 600. So as per the statement, we are adding 200 to their individual shares. It means we are adding 200 with 1000, 200 with 1200, and 200 with 600. So we'll get the new value, and the new value is 1200, 1400 and 800. Now we have to calculate the ratio for this. So I'm writing here 1200 is to 1400 is to 800. So if you simplify, you will get the ratio of 6 is to 7 is to 4. So this is a new ratio if we add 200 rupees to their individual shares. So just look at this. Here the individual share, if we, so we have profit is 2800, so total part is 14. If you divide, you will get 200. So individual part is 200, and the amount we are adding is also 200. If it is same, you can simply add 1 to the ratio. It means if you look at the answer, you will understand. So the given ratio is 5 is to 6 is to 3, and the result is 6 is to 7 is to 4. It is one value is added with a given value. So you can directly add if and only if one part is equal to the amount we are going to add. So if it is different, you have to use this traditional method. If it is same, you can directly add one value and write the answer. No need to solve and do all these things. Next. The ratio of number of students studying in a school A, B and C is 5 is to 6 is to 8. If the number of students studying in each school is increased by 30%, 25% and again 25%. So in the previous problem, they are adding the amount to their individual share. But we are adding, in this problem, we are adding the percentage. So write the ratio ABC. We have 5 is to 6 is to 3. Here we are adding 30% to the ratio A and 25% to B and C. So 5 plus 30% of this 5 is to 6 plus 25% of 6. Again, so this is 8. 8 plus 25% of 8. So if you simplify, so 30% of 5 is 1.5, and then 6 plus 25% of 6 is again 1.5. 8 plus 25% of 8 is 2. So if you simplify, you will get 6.5 is to 7.5 is to 10. So now look at this. So in our definition we have studied, ratio is the simplest form. Here the ratio is in decimal. Ratio should not be in decimal. We have to make it integer. So if you multiply this ratio with 2, you will get 13 is to 14 is to 20. So 13 is to 14 is to 20 is the new ratio if we add 30%, 25% and 25% with the existing ratio. So here look at this. Ratio between B and C in this example is 6 is to 8. I am leaving A, I am considering only B and C. Here we are increasing 25% to B and 25% to C. If the percentage increase is same, the ratio will be same even at the end of calculation. So look at the result of B and C. Here we got 7 into 5 is 15. So look at this, this is ratio. If you simplify, you will get the ratio 3 is to 4. This 3 is to 4 is the ratio. This ratio will remain same if the percentage increase is same. So if percentage increase is same, the ratio will also be same. So don't compare with A, I am comparing only with B and C. Let's move on to the last type of ratio and proportion. It is combined ratio. What is combined ratio? Here we have three values. A is to B, they have given 4 is to 5. Then next, they have given B is to C. So I am writing like this, B is to C, and the value is 5 is to 9. Now the question is, what is the ratio between A is to B is to C? So in case of combined ratio, look at the common term between two ratios. So in this, B is the common term and this value is same. So we can directly write 4 is to 5 is to 9 is a new ratio. So if the common term is same, you can directly add this, directly write ratio like ratio. Look at the second example. Here, X is to Y is 4 is to 3. Similarly, Y is to Z is 5 is to 6. Here the common term is Y and the value of Y is different in these two ratios. So multiply the ratio with some common factor. I am multiplying the ratio 1 with 5 and multiplying the ratio 2 with 3. So if I multiply, I will get 20 is to 15. And this value is 15 is to 18. So here the common term is same. So the new ratio is 20 is to 15 is to 18. So this is the concept of combined ratio. So if common term is same, you can directly write the ratio. If it is different, multiply with some factor and make the common term equal and then write the ratio. Let's discuss a problem based on this. Here they have given the ratio, that is Sita and Geeta age are in the ratio of 3 is to 4. Sita and Geeta ratio is 3 is to 4. Geeta and Lata's age are in the ratio of 4 is to 7. Geeta and Lata's in ratio of 4 is to 7. Then Lata and Ram age are in the ratio of 7:9. What is the ratio of Sita and Ram? What is the ratio of Sita and Ram? So look at the common term here. So G, Gita ratio is common. So this value is same. So we can simply connect 3:4:7 with Sita, Gita and Lata. So look at the common term here. Lata's value is also common. So include the Ram's ratio. So the new ratio is 3:4:7:9 because the common term is similar in both the ratio. So what is our question? Sita's and Ram age. So take the Sita's and Ram age separately. So it is 3:9. So 3:9 is not a ratio because we have to simplify this. So if you simplify, you will get 1:3. So 1:3 is the ratio of Sita and Ram age. So in combined ratio, remember the common term is similar, common term value is same, you can directly write. If it is not same, you have to multiply with some factor and make it equal and then write the ratio. So I hope you have understand the ratio concept. So we'll move on to the partnership. So what is partnership? Two or more than two persons doing business together. Okay. So let's assume A and B are doing business. A and B are doing business. So A has invested some 5,000 rupees in business and B has invested the amount 10,000 rupees in the business. They are doing the business for 1 year. At the end of 1 year, if their profit is 3,000, how will they share this profit? So will they divide this profit equally? That is 1,500? 1,500? No. Because the investment of A and B is different. They have to share their profit based on their investment. So A investment is less, so he will get the less amount in the profit. So use the ratio concept. So 5,000:10,000 is the investment. So if you simplify, you will get 1:2. Here, the profit of 1000 rupees goes to A and the remaining 2000 rupees goes to B. So use the ratio concept and find the answer. So profit and investment means profit will increase if investment increases. So investment and profit is directly proportional to each other. So similarly, look at the other example. A and B has invested the same amount, 10,000. Again 10,000. So after 6 months B left. So after 6 months B left and A continues the business for 1 year. So at the end of 1 year, assume their profit is 18,000. How will they share this amount? Will they share 9,000 and 9,000? No, because A has invested the amount for 1 year and B has invested the amount only for 6 months. So if they are going to share this profit, they have to divide again by the number of time duration they have invested. So A has invested 10,000 rupees for 12 months. B has invested the amount 10,000 rupees for 6 months. So their ratio is 12:6. If you divide, you will get 2:1. Use the ratio concept and you will get the answer. 12,000 is A share and 6,000 is B share. So use the ratio concept and find the answer. So again, profit will increase if time increases. So profit depends on both investment and time. In this two example, we have discussed a fixed duration with different amount and fixed amount with different duration. But in actual problem, you will get the question by combining these two. For example, A has invested the amount 5,000, B has invested the amount 10,000. A continues the business for 1 year and B left the business in 3 months. So like this, you will get investment and time based problem in partnership. Okay. So let's discuss a simple example like this. Three friends, A, B and C, started a business by investing amount 1,20,000, 1,35,000 and 1,50,000 respectively. Find out the share of each out of an annual profit of ₹56,700. So three friends started the business with 1,20,000, and the ratio we have to calculate, and 1,50,000. So now find out the ratio between these three. If you simplify, you will get the ratio as 8:9:10. Find out share of each out of an annual profit, 56%. So look at this, use the ratio concept. So the total parts will be 27 parts. So among 27 parts, A will get 8 parts. So multiply this with the value 56,700. So among 27 parts, B will get 9 parts. 56,700. Among 27 parts, C will get 10 parts. 56,700. So if you simplify, you will get the answer directly. So 16,800, you will get 18,900, and you will get 21,000. So simply find the ratio and find individual share. So in this partnership, we may have three types of problem. So we will get a problem based on two partners or three partners, and the third type will be additional investment. So particular person is investing that investing extra money after some periods. So we'll be discussing these three types of problem one by one. So first, A started a business investing ₹12,000. After 5 months, B joined with a capital of 9,000. At the end of 1 year, the total profit was 4,416. What is A share? Okay. So in our earlier example, we have discussed only with same amount, different period, or different amount, same period. But in this problem, they have given the different amount as well as time period is also different. Okay. So A has invested the amount and B has also invested the amount. A invested the amount of 12,000. B invested 9,000. So how much month A has invested? So A's amount is in business for entire 1 year. So it means 12 months. But B has invested the amount after 5 months. So it means B's amount is in business for only 7 months. So B invested after 5 months. So 12 minus 5 is 7. So multiply these two to calculate the ratio. So 12,000 into 12 is 2. 9,000 into 7. So the ratio will be, the ratio of the profit will be shared based on these values. If you simplify, you will get 16:7. So what is our question? What is the share of A? So total part is 23. 16 parts belongs to A. And what is the profit? 4,416. So if you simplify, you will get 3,072. So 3,072 is a profit which A got after 1 year. So remember, if you are having different value and different time period, you have to multiply these two and find the new ratio. If it is same, you can consider any one. So let's discuss one more problem in two partners. A and B started a business investing 42,000 and 57,000 respectively. But B left the business after 8 months. So in the previous example, B joined after 5 months. Here B left the business after 8 months. Find the difference between share of profits of A and B if the total profit at the end of year is 26,000. So A has invested the amount 42,000 and B has invested the amount 57,000. So A's money is in business for entire 12 months, but B left after 8 months. It means B's money is in business for only 8 months. So multiply this and find the new ratio. So if I multiply, I am leaving the 0, 42 into 12, 57 into 8. So calculate the new ratio, 21:19. So what is the question? Find the difference between the share of profits of A and B if total profit at the end of year is, year was 26,600. So don't calculate the value of A and B separately. Calculate the difference only, which we have discussed in the ratio and problem, ratio and proportion problem earlier. So use that concept only. Don't calculate this 21/40 into 26,000 and you'll get the value. Similarly, 19/40 into 26,000 and get the value. Subtract this. Don't do this. Okay. So here the difference between the profit is different between difference in their profit is 2. So 2/40 into profit. So you will get 1300. You can simply get the answer by using this form. Okay, let's move on to the second type in this. So this problem is based on three partners. Okay, so A started a business investing rupees 50,000. After 6 months, B joined with rupees 75,000. After another 6 months, C also joined with them with rupees 1.25 lakhs. What should be the ratio in which the profits are shared by 3% respectively at the end of 2 years? Okay, so A, B and C has started invested the amount in this business. So A has invested 50,000, B invested 75,000, C invested 1,25,000. Okay, so A has invested this amount at the beginning itself. So A's money is involved in the business for entire 2 years, that is 24 months. B's money is involved only 18 months. So because B has joined after 6 months only. So similarly, C has joined after 6 months. So C's money is involved in business only for 12 months. So calculate the new ratio based on this value. So 50,000 into 24 is to 75,000 into 18 is to 1,25,000 into 12. So if you simplify, your new ratio will be 8:9. So here remember, B and C invested in this business after a particular period. So C's money is involved in the business only for 12 months, that is 1 year, and C's money is involved in business for 1.5 years, that is 18 months, and A's money is involved in business for 24, that is 2 years. So simply multiply the amount invested and the time duration and calculate the new ratio. It is similar to two partner, but we have to consider third value also. So let's move on to the fourth type in this, additional investments. Okay, A started a business by investing rupees 25,000. 6 months later, B joined by investing rupees 15,000. After 6 months, B invested an additional amount of rupees 15,000. So in the earlier example, after 6 months, C joined. But in this example, B itself is investing more money in the same business. So at the end of third year, they earn profit of 2,47,000. What is B's share in this profit? Here, A has invested the amount 25,000. B has invested the amount 15,000. So now consider only these two items. So A has invested the amount 25,000 and they are dividing the profit at the end of third year. So if it is third year, we have to multiply with 36, that is 36 months. 3 into 12, 36. Okay. Now look at the B's investment. B has invested 15,000 after 6 months. So it means this 15,000 is involved in the business for only 30 months. Also, B has invested 15,000 more in the same business. So B again invested another 15,000. So this 15,000 was invested after another 6 months. So this 15,000 involved in the business for only 24 months. Okay. So in this example, we have to add B's value like this. So look at the ratio I'm writing here. 25,000 into 36. This is the ratio which we use for that. So here B's first 15,000 is involved in the business for 30 months, and B's second 15,000 is involved in the business for only 24 months. So now simplify this. So multiply and add the value and you will get the ratio 30:27. If you simplify this value, you will get 10:9. So the ratio of the new ratio is 10:7. Okay. So what is our question? What is B's share in the profit? So we have to calculate B's share. So what is the total part? 10 plus 9, 19 parts. So among this 19 parts, B's share belongs to 9. And if you multiply this with the total value 2,04,000, and if you simplify, you will get 1,07,000. So there is a question: can we take after 6 months and another one like C? No. If you take, you will get confused with the new ratio. So B itself has invested the amount in business. There is no new person is involving in the business. So this investment is added with the B's ratio, not with the new ratio. So don't take C. Okay. So I hope you have understand the concept of ratio and proportion and partnership with this example. So practice more problem in this ratio and proportion, because this ratio and proportion we will use this topic in time and work, time and distance, ages, and we have discussed in the partnership. So practice more problem with the ratio and proportion. Also try to practice in online, so it will calculate the time to solve the problem. So don't practice the problem with pen and paper. So try to solve the problem through online, so you will get the real time experience of campus interview. Okay. So revise this topic. This video is available in our prep.placementseason.com and app.placementseason.com. Also this video is available in our YouTube channel and Facebook videos. So you can watch this video anytime and practice this problem. So what is Prepare a Placement Season 2019 batch? So Prepare a Placement Season is an exclusive training program for 2019 batch. So in this Prepare a Placement Season test package, we have 2 topic wise coding tests and 5 aptitude tests on every week. So every Monday you will get access to 5 aptitude topic, and it is topic wise aptitude test and 2 topic wise coding tests. And you will get access to 1 coding assessment and 1 aptitude full length test for every 2 weeks. Similarly, then for 1 month, you will get access to 1 national level coding content. So these tests are included in Prepare Placement Season package. So apart from this, you will get access to company specific mock test. So practice the problem in this Prepare a Placement Season. Also watch this live session and concept videos. Practice more problem So as I said earlier, I'll tell you about the offers and discount coupon codes available in the placement season. We have 50% discount on Prepare with Placement Season test package. If you use the code Prepare with Placement Season, the coupon code is in red color, Prepare with Placement Season. If you use this coupon code at the checkout, so you will get 50% discount on Prepare with Placement Season. So this Prepare with Placement Season coupon code is valid till February 10th. So you can use this code and get 50% discount. Also, you can take free mock test on every Sunday to get practice with company specific tests. So you can use our free resources from Placement Season. You can use our prep.placementseason.com. This is exclusively for preparation. And if you want any internship, you can register in our internship.placementseason.com and apply for the suitable internship. So if you have any questions, you can send an email to friends@placementseason.com or WhatsApp 9894-9300. So next week we'll discuss allegation and mixture on Wednesday at 8 p.m. So practice problems on ratio and proportion and get ready for allegation and mixture on next Wednesday. See you on next Wednesday, and thank you guys